Hello, I'm Dr. Marla Shapiro. I'm a past president of the North American Menopause Society, and it gives me great pleasure to be here this morning with Dr. Samara Kudari, who is an associate professor of epidemiology and clinical and translational science at the Institute Graduate School of Public Health at the University of Pittsburgh. She, as well, is a current member of the NAMS Board of Trustees. She's a fellow of the American Heart Association. She is also a research expert on menopause and cardiovascular disease. So who better to talk to me about heart disease and menopause? Welcome.
Thank you so much, Marla. It's a pleasure for me to be today with you and to talk on menopause and cardiovascular disease, which is
the... Let's hop right in there. For so many years, menopause is linked to heart disease. We know that women start later than men. But what are the main menopause characteristics that are relevant to the risk of cardiovascular disease that we as clinicians need to keep our eye on?
Yes, so we have been really learning a lot recently with observational studies and the research that has been focusing on menopause and cardiovascular disease. And I would like to focus in particular on, I would say, four of these. Age at natural menopause is one such important characteristics of menopause that has been studied. We know that early age at natural menopause is a marker of cardiovascular health. And studies have shown that Black, Hispanic, as well as women with low or short menstrual cycle, as well as those who smoke and with low parity, actually experience an earlier age at menopause. Interestingly, age at menopause has been shown to be to some sort of a genetic factor or marker here, and there is a link between ovarian aging and somatic aging in a molecular pathways, actually suggesting that age at menopause could impact cardiovascular system through molecular pathways. So that's one aspect. So we know early age at menopause could be a marker of higher cardiovascular risk. The second aspect that I want to touch base on is the perimenopause stage. Perimenopause stage is when women start to have irregularity of her menstrual cycles that actually extend for 12 months after menopause. This stage of women life research has showed that women become vulnerable to cardiometabolic risk as well as vascular health. During this stage, we know that there is an acceleration of cardiovascular risk. Another characteristics of menopause that has been studied well is vasomotor symptoms. Women who experience greater vasomotor symptoms has been shown to be related, or the higher or the frequency of vasomotor symptoms has been shown to be related to cardiovascular risk factor. These include lipids, inflammatory marker, as well as insulin and subclinical measures of atherosclerosis. The timing of vasomotor symptoms seem also to matter when we talk about a cardiovascular risk. And finally, I want to touch base on estrogen, because really this is the, you know, the what drive our attention from the beginning. So endogenous estrogen, unfortunately, did not give us, you know, the direct, you know, kind of, you know, relationship that we are expecting. But there are lots of, you know, concern about the way we have been doing research related to this important biological marker. In particular, studies has focused mainly cross-sectional and postmenopausal. But when we start to look at trajectories of estrogen over time, endogenous estrogen, we are seeing actually a link between, you know, high estrogen during reproductive life and protective effect on carotid atherosclerosis later in life. So these, I would say, the main features of menopause that has been linked so far, you know, with some robust research to cardiovascular risk.
So that gives us some areas that we can look at in terms of a predictive model. But as women transition through menopause, most will experience some type of change in their cardiometabolic health. And are these changes universal, and are they all menopause related, or are some of them just aging related?
Yeah, this is a very important question. And I believe, you know, we put our hand now on specific changes that we believe could be menopause related. I will start by lipids. We know now that women, as they transition through menopause, and in particular during the 1 year before and after menopause, they experience a sharp increase in their LDL cholesterol or total cholesterol. For, you know, good cholesterol, the story is not as clear as possible, but we are working on that to better understand what's going on. Another aspect that seem to be menopause related is the metabolic syndrome. We know also as women hit menopause or during the menopausal transition, we see a steep increase in the incidence of metabolic syndrome around that time. Vascular health, I would say structural and functional marker of the vasculature, also found to be changes during that time period. In particular, the intima media thickness, the lumen of the adventitial diameter, as well as most recently, we showed the stiffness of the artery actually is menopause, could be menopause related during this period of women's life. And finally, I want to touch base on the change in fat in women as they transition through menopause. We are now kind of, you know, had data support that the fat accumulation move from other part of the body to now become more focused on the central area. And we actually have data showing an increase in central fat and a reduction in mass, in lean mass in those women. So these are, you know, when happened together, it's kind of concerning, you know, and I believe, you know, we need to make sure that this is clear.
So you've touched a little bit on LDL. What about high density lipoprotein, the so-called good cholesterol, as we often call it? Is there a pattern in terms of what women can expect through the transition through menopause?
Yeah, so we really, you know, kind of, you know, not sure as well as for HDL or the good cholesterol. There are studies suggesting that HDL actually declining as women transition through menopause. There are studies showing that it's kind of increasing, and some studies shows it's fluctuating. However, the main problem with HDL that we are measuring HDLC, or what we call the total cholesterol content of HDL particle. HDL is a heterogeneous family of particle with different composition and functionality, and we are just touching base on one metric. It seems from the literature, as well as Mendelian analysis, randomization analysis, that this metrics that we are using as a clinician, as well as in our research, may not better capture the cardiovascular feature of good cholesterol. We are working now on studies where we are touching based on other metrics, such as the particles themselves, the content of the lipids and triglycerides, as well as the functionality of the particles. And we are seeing some preliminary finding supporting HDL to become actually dysfunctional during menopause. And, you know, but we still need to better characterize what's going on and how that could be linked to cardiovascular risk.
So we touched a little bit on what happens in terms of the anatomical location of fat, sort of that centripetal in the middle. But now we're talking about the concept of heart fat, so to speak, as a novel cardiovascular risk factor. And maybe that in itself is even more atherogenic than the abdominal fat, where we think about metabolic syndrome increasing and inflammatory markers increasing. So since women during the menopause have that change in fat deposition towards centripetally, are they now at higher risk of having greater heart fat? And how do we explain that?
Yes, you know, so once we, you know, actually, if you think about it scientifically, what make women have a shift in their fat into the abdomen is because at certain point, you know, we are usually stored the fat in the subcutaneous area. But as women transition through menopause, there is a change happening in estrogen receptors, which play a very important role in maintaining the functionality of adipose tissue. Then we start to see this kind of shift happening. Now, with that shift happening and the reduction of energy expenditure in those women, the fat, the storage in subcutaneous fat become, you know, extended to its maximum. Then there become an overflow of free fatty acid to other organs in the body, including the heart, where we expect to see an increase in the fat around the heart. And actually, studies showed so far that postmenopausal women have greater heart fat in comparison to premenopausal women, independent of aging, physical activity, BMI, and race, ethnicity. So this fat, yes, indeed, seemed to be higher after menopause as compared to premenopausal women. And also, we found that this fat, not only just, you know, higher without any impact, but it actually could be associated with increased risk of subclinical measures of atherosclerosis in these women, such as coronary artery calcification.
So before I let you go, as healthcare practitioners, when we're counseling these women, what can we counsel them to do about heart fat, as well as these other cardiometabolic changes that accompany the menopause transition, aside from those patients where we feel we need to jump in with medication. But what other advice can we offer them to be able to take back some of the control?
I think, you know, we are lucky to have some evidence available supporting for heart fat that, you know, being physically active would actually reduce this heart fat, you know, accumulation in women. But I want to mention an important aspect that most recently Circulation has published a paper about awareness of cardiovascular disease as a leading cause of death in women. For a period from 2009 to 2019, awareness was 65% in 2009, and it's dropped to 49% in 2019. This is really disturbing for me as, you know, a person who is interested in women's health. And I believe, you know, it requires us to work together in order to increase the awareness. Awareness is an important part when it's come to prevention. And, you know, if we want to focus on lifestyle intervention and a healthy, you know, life with, you know, diet and stopping smoking and maintaining, you know, weight, I think we want to make sure that, you know, women are aware that this period is critical. So they have the motivation to work on, you know, these aspects as they protect their healthy heart.
Pretty shocking to see that decline. Thank you so much for joining us. It was just a terrific session. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.